Assalamu alaikum and good morning to you, my dear friends. You are tuning in to the Voice of the Hanuman Mission, our weekly educational segment entitled The Beauty of Knowing. I am yours truly, Mahanji Dr. Balim Chedi, and as we get to the end of 2013, it is my privilege once again with your support and the way you have received these segments to give me the energy to keep going. Now, today, because it is the Christmas season, and because we believe many of our Christian brothers and sisters would also be paying special emphasis to Mass, to prayer, to their religious texts, we thought, based on a question, that we'll touch briefly on our most prominent Hindu text. Now, many of you would know or would have heard the word Ramayana. Some people say Ramayana, Ramayana. We have different ways we pronounce it. But for simplicity's sake, we'll say Ramayana. Ramayana is two words. Ram, iron means a lake. So it means you put them together. Ramayana means the lake containing the deeds of Sri Ram. That's what basically Ramayana means. Now, what is a Ramayana? A Ramayana, we know, is a physical text that carries a lot of deep philosophy, deep recollection of events and happenings that actually took place. Some people refer to Ramayana as a story. It's not necessarily a story. It's a story in caption. It has captured real life experiences that took place. So it is not a Nancy story, so we'll dispel that doubt today. The power of Ramayana is such. If somebody will come into your house, a priest, Mahant, Sadhu, whoever, and they gave you, just hand you a Ramayana and say, here, could you take this book inside for me, please? You would hold a Ramayana text very casually, walk in your house. If somebody came to you, they give you the same book, say, could you take this Ramayana inside for me, please? The word now just changed from book to a Ramayana. You'd become a little more cautious. And you become a little more sensitive. You wonder, did I fast? Did I not fast? Should I do this? Shouldn't I? Your mental state starts to click. And then, conscientiously, you would hold the Ramayana, the text, the sacred text, you would take it inside. And thirdly, somebody walk in and they give you a Ramayana that's wrapped in a red cloth. And they said, son or daughter, my dear friend, can you take this Ramayana and put it on the altar? Instantly, you get defensive, and I'm telling you from experience, this happens. You get defensive because first thing you say, well, Pandit, or Baba, or Swami, hang on a second, I'll get somebody. Because most people, Hindus, even though we are non-vegetarians, or vegetarians alike, we are very conscious of certain things that's important. So Ramayana, like the Bible, like the Holy Quran, like everything else, carries a deep, significant meaning. Now, we know Ramayana having seven khans, seven sections, Balkhan, Ayodhyakar, Sundarkhan, Lankakar, Uttarkhan, all the different khans. And a khan represents a section, an incremental section in the Ramayana. So we have always heard about the different sections of Ramayana. It's a story that's narrated, as people say. Now the question is, what happens beyond the spectrum of seven Ramayana? Seven khans of Ramayana, I should say. There's a section at the end of Ramayana called Kaliyug Mahima. As most of you know, we live in the age of Kaliyug, the dark iron age. I said the age of moral decadence, age of corruption, age of wrongdoing. I'm not telling you what I want to tell you, I'm telling you what the text says. But at the end of the Ramayana, it's called Kaliyug Mahima. There's a whole section that deals with the issues today that we see, that we experience it. So many people have called me and asked me, Sir Pandit, why we don't hear about life today? So the reason why I'm answering the question to you, when you have your Pandits come to do your satsang, when you have your Swamis, your Mahants, your Sadhus, or your Ramayana group come to do your satsang, tell them you want to hear Kaliyug Mahima. Skip all of the regular khans that you know. Go towards the end and let them do for you in your homes or your temples, for those of you looking at this. For the Pandits, my dear colleagues who are looking, start explaining Kaliyug Mahima. Explain to our Hindu community the things that we are expected to see and why we are seeing some of the things we see. It's written in the text, my dear friends. A lot of times, I'm not sure why It has never been explained. But the question was asked, and I made a promise to answer every question that asked, obviously respecting and be mindful of everybody else. So as I summarize this, Ramayana is our main scriptural text, and the reason why many of us as Trinidadians and Guyanese and out of the diaspora pay so much attention to Ramayana over many of the other texts, because it tells of the life experience of separation when Lord Sri Rama left and had to leave Ayodhya to go to the foreign for exile for 14 years. Many of the indentured servants that we know went to Guyana first, 7 years later went to Trinidad and work on the sugar estates. And the yearning desire to return home was always there. And that is why the context of Ramayana, because it is our life story and life experience, this is why Ramayana has become the most important facet of our lifetime, because it replicates our journey and the journey of Prabhu Sri Ram, something that we can relate to, where the family we left behind, there's always a yearning to go back there. My dear friends, this is the Yuletide season. To our Christian brothers and sisters, we bid you the blessings of Christ as you celebrate Christmas, as we all enter into the pathway to welcome a new year. I thank all of you for your support, and may the good Lord bless and guide and protect you. Now that you know, through the beauty of knowing, I am Mahanji, Dr. Balyam Jedi. With the knowledge you have today, I ask you, you be the judge. Jai Sitaram.